I chose not to in this case.
Can you tell me why you chose not to in this case?
I had a connection with a staff member, Mr. Peterson, and I made the decision to send the photo lineup over to Mr. Peterson to complete it.
And I'm guessing when you, well, I would like to ask you, going back to your Facebook warrant, when you found out the years was wrong, why didn't you fix it?
I was in preparation for this trial, and I decided not to due to the fact that it could take several weeks to a month to do this, and I had enough information to show communication between the defendant and Vanessa Robinson.
But don't you think a defendant or even a victim would deserve that? The right dates?
Objection, argumentative.
Well, Your Honor, I'm just trying to see why.
Okay, then rephrase, because that system is argumentative, so rephrase, please. Yeah.
So, I'm trying to understand the importance of these dates are very important. Do you agree?
I do, sir.
So, do you agree that they should have been fixed?
I should have had the correct dates in the first place.
So, in the first place, when you find out they're not the correct dates, don't you think you should have corrected it? No matter if it took a couple of weeks, a couple of months, whatever?
Well, in this case, the purpose of the search warrant was to show communication between Vanessa Robinson and the defendant, and to show the link between both subjects. And I believe I had enough with that information that I had received already from Facebook.
Okay. Saying that's your... Okay, so basically you got all the records from 2015.
That's correct.
What age would Vanessa be in 2015?
She could have been, it depends on the year, but she could have been, when I made contact with her, she was 14, and she could have also been 13 in 2015.
I would like to give you her birthday on the report, but for refresh your memory.
Okay.
As soon as I can find it.
The state's admitted one with her birth dates on it.
Okay, so let's tell the detective. Okay.
Can someone pass me a one, please? Thank you. Is it your request that he have a look at this?
Yes.
All right, so detective, I'm going to research exhibit one. If you wouldn't mind just taking a look at that.
So, in 2015 is where your alleged communication between the defendant and the victim happened.
Well, Your Honor, I'm going to jump to the interruption.
Sure.
So, does he understand he's opening the door to Facebook now? Because he's talking, he keeps going over and over this 2015 communication, and that directly opens the door to all the Facebook
comments. I believe you were aware of that, right?
Yes.
Asking specific questions.
I'm going over what date that he said this, that I'm basically destroying his Facebook evidence, because his Facebook, I'm going over the dates that is totally wrong in the Facebook. So to prove that, her charges of under 14 don't exist. Okay. So which is six charges under 14.
Right.
I'm proving that this is impossible.
No, but what Ms. Collins is saying is by the questioning that you're going down the lane and talking about specifically about the Facebook records is that you're opening the door for him to, you know, defend the information that he received in those Facebook records.
Oh, he can defend it.
Okay.
He's on stand.
She just wanted to make sure you were aware of that.
Right.
That means they're going to be admitted. You understand that, right?
What?
What?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. All right, great. So let's go back.
Officer Martinez, in 2015, how old would she be?
Well, she could have been, she could be 14 and she could also be 13.
Because
her date of birth is January 25th. So before January 25th, she would have been 13 years old. So both ages during that whole year, to answer your question.
So basically, you're saying if you're a year off, like you said you were, your years would be January 25th, 2014, January 24th, 2016.
Your Honor, I'm going to object. That mischaracterizes the testimony. He said his date was off in the search warrant, no place else, so I don't know.
So I'm going to just ask that you clarify, because we're talking about a lot of dates, so date for Facebook, date
Your
for
Honor,
events.
If his date is off.
Just re-ask the question to him, please.
Okay. So you have admitted several times that your date was off. So if your date is off, it would make your year, oh, I can ask you, would it make her a year older?
Objection, big. I'm sorry, I don't understand.
I'm a little confused. Would you please
Your Honor, if somebody's a year off.
Okay, I can't talk to me. You've got to ask him a question.
Okay, officer, if somebody's a year off, Detective Martinez, if somebody's a year off, and then you correct that year, would they be a year older?
Your Honor, objection, vague, foundation.
Sustained as to vague. And actually, officer, do you understand? If you understand the question, feel free to answer it.
My clerical error doesn't change her age. If that's
so,
what you're asking.
So basically, no matter if it is 2014, which
she would have been 12 or 13, sir.
So you got her birthday up there again? Can you take a look at that again? Your statements I'm going to read your statements. How old did you ask her in your voluntary statement she was?
Well, objection.
It's his statement.
Are you asking what her answer was to his question?
No, I'm asking him, how old did she tell him she was?
It's his statement. That is hearsay.
During your interview with the alleged victim, how old did she tell you she was?
Same objection, Your Honor. It's foundational, too, because how old did she tell him what her birthday was, or regarding the incidents, so.
Can you clarify the question, please?
Yeah, Your Honor, it's very important that they know.
And, sir, I need you to ask him a question.
What day was your interview done, officer?
July 23rd of 2015.
How old was your alleged victim at that time?
Just 14.
So, during your investigation of this, when you went to Fatburger to interview the employees or to get the tape, what did you see?
Sir, I did not go to Fatburger.
You didn't go to Fatburger?
I did not.
So the place that your alleged victim met the defendant, you didn't go?
I did not.
Can I ask why?
I did not have a set date and time, and I did not go over there to, I did not go over there to confirm that they were there or not.
So you did not go to Fatburger to confirm that the alleged victim and defendant was together?
I did not.
Is there a reason not to? Can I understand your reasoning, Detective Martin?
The interview was almost a year after the fact, and I did not have a specific date and time to locate, in this case, any information that would have showed them that they were there. So I decided not to go over there to look for them.
You, all these crimes, allegedly, where did all these crimes take place?
At the defendant's residence.
Did you go there and investigate?
I went over January of 2016 in attempts to look to make contact with the defendant.
So you went into his apartment January when?
Did not go into the apartment.
You didn't go in the alleged crime scene place?
I did not.
So, you did not go into the defendant. What day did you go into the defendant's apartment?
I did not go into the defendant's apartment.
So you've never been in the defendant's apartment?
Not inside, no.
So did this happen on the outside of the apartment, Detective Martinez?
The incidents were alleged to have happened inside the apartment.
So why wouldn't you go inside?
I made the decision not to go inside the apartment.
So let me get this straight. You made the decision not to go to Fatburger, and you made the decision not to go into the apartment. Am I correct?
That's correct.
Is that common for the police department not to go to a crime scene or alleged crime scene?
In some cases, we don't go to the crime scene or we don't have the availability to get into the residences due to the time between the allegation is made and the time that the incident occurs. In some cases, we don't have enough probable cause just to go in someone's apartment or residence based just on an allegation. And during my contact in January of 2016, I made that decision not to go in to the apartment, but to just attempt to talk to the defendant over the phone and cordially schedule an interview with him.
So basically, what you're saying is you're trying to get a confession without going any investigation.
Objection, argumentative.
So. Did you want the defendant to confess on the phone?
Objection, argumentative.
Let's, can you rephrase it, please?
Did you ever call the defendant?
I did not.
So you didn't call the defendant ever?
I did not.
So you never went to Fatburger, you never went into the house, and you never called the defendant. Am I correct?
That's correct.
And you got the Facebook dates wrong. Search warrant wrong. Am I correct?
That's correct.
How did you go about receiving the defendant's phone number?
I believe the defendant had called me that same day I made contact, so I believe that's how I obtained the phone number, or one of the ways I obtained the phone number, but I'm not sure.
Let me refresh your memory. Can you read this?
What is that?
We're helping refresh.
Right. What are you asking?
It's the volunteer statement where he says how he obtained the phone number.
Well, objection to the narrative and it needs to
be. Would it help if you read some of this so you can refresh your memory of how you got the phone?
Yes.
Thank you. Officer,
can I give him a page number, please?
Can I have a page number for the
detective? I need a page number.
Is there a specific page you want me to look at?
18.
Okay.
Does that refresh your memory how you got the number?
No, it does not.
That doesn't. So you have no idea how you got the defendant's number?
I don't recall, sir, how I obtained that phone number through my investigative steps. Because the defendant called me that day I left my business card.
Can you read page 18?
I did. I reviewed it, sir.
So can you read it for me, please, so I can understand more of myself?
Well, objection, calls for hearsay, and argumentative.
So. You can't read it because it's hearsay unless you have an exception to the hearsay rule you'd like to apply.
Yes, Your Honor, it's not hearsay if it's his statement.
That's
in the police report. If it's his statement asking a question, obviously the If he says it's his statement, then that's him asking the questions. So he should be able to read that, what he said.
Okay, so he's looked at that. That doesn't refresh his recollection. So if there's another method you'd like to use, that's fine.
Okay. So, you're saying when the defendant called you, that's when you obtained his number?
It's possible. I don't know for sure.
There has to be, you have to have, I mean, do you have any idea how you obtained the defendant's number?
Well, in my experience, you could obtain it many ways. You could obtain it with the victim providing it, the witness providing it, a suspect providing it, a person of interest providing it, police records, old police records, social media information. There's a lot of ways we obtain specific phone numbers, but I don't recall in this case how I obtained your specific phone number, sir.
So even after reading page 18, you didn't understand?
Whatever you're trying to get in, if you believe there's a way to get that in, then you need to go ahead and do that. Otherwise, this has been asked and answered literally at least 9 times, and we need to move on.
That's correct.
You have the defendant's phone number. Am I correct?
That's correct.
Why did you attempt to make contact only one time?
That conversation with the defendant, as I recall, say that he did not have any knowledge of who Vanessa Robinson was and did not want to talk about the matter. So I made that decision not to proceed to make contact with the defendant because of his response.
So when the defendant was taken into custody, I'm sure you went and interviewed him. What was said?
I did not interview the defendant when the defendant was taken into custody.
You never interviewed the defendant?
I did not.
Can I ask why?
Well, Your Honor, can we approach?
He wasn't on the arrest team, as I'm sure the court remembers, and I don't know if he has read his rights and invoked his right to an attorney, so he's getting dangerously close to that information. This detective wasn't there. So I just want to make sure we don't have some invocation of a right to counsel on the record that...
I wasn't read my Miranda rights.
Did you ask to speak to an attorney?
No, I didn't.
Okay. So, what he's calling is doing is she's trying to protect the constitutional rights of you. You know, you have a right to remain silent, you have a right to an attorney, and so if you invoke those things, then the problem is that you invoke those things would be a problem. She's just trying to make sure those interests are protected.
I was never read my Miranda rights. I was never formally arrested. So Well, I was never given any rights, so when he called, I mean, when I was in jail.
Could you just say, did you ever attempt to contact, did you ever attempt to contact him that you're reading? And like he said no, and you can say why, and then move on.
Okay. Thank you.
So, at any point did you attempt to contact me?
Sir, yes, I did.
At what point did you attempt to contact me?
On two occasions, once in person at the residence and over the phone when you contacted me.
So me contacting you is attempt for you contacting me?
That's considered contact, yes, sir. And I attempted to schedule that interview to sit down and talk about the investigation, and you did not want to talk about the matter. So that was the extent of the contact I had with you.
Getting back to the Facebook and your Facebook mark. Is from what month is your Facebook warrant from?
January 1st of 2015, I believe.
To when?
I believe it was present time would have been on April of 2015, I believe. Without looking at that actual warrant, that's just an estimation on my end.
Can I refresh your memory?
Yes. The warrant has a clerical error as well. It reads January 1st of 2015 to February, April 2016.
Can you explain what a clerical mistake is?
It's just something that was typed in the report or a document that I did not intend to put in, but after proofreading didn't catch it, or the other person proofread didn't catch the error as well.
Another person proofread it?
That's correct.
So, you made a mistake with this date, and another person who proofread it also made a mistake.
Of proofreading, yes, sir.
What did the warrant supposed to be? What the date supposed to be?
Supposed to be to April 2016.
So the three names you have, Raymond Davis, 3388630, Poker Star, Raymond Davis. Did you get a warrant and search the Facebook profile of Poker Star Raymond Davis?
Yes, I did.
Can you tell me what you found?
Nothing was, I don't believe anything was taken out of that user profile to... Nothing pertained to the investigation, I believe, without looking at the records with any, and that would include any communication with Vanessa Robinson or Raymond Davis, but there was a warrant that was served on that user profile.
So, the second profile, poker star Raymond Davis, you found no communication between the alleged victim and the defendant?
Without looking at those records, I don't believe so, sir.
So everything you found was in Raymond Davis, 3388630.
That's correct.
While you looked through them, 2,000 pages, you said? Was it 2,000 pages?
The three usernames, it's over 2,000 pages. I don't know exactly how many pages total.
Somehow, the state did not give me 2,000 pages.
Fair question, sir.
So you looked over 2,000 pages of Facebook records, right?
Yes.
Did you give those 2,000 pages to the DA?
I pulled the pages pertaining to this investigation to the district attorney's office.
So basically you weaved through 2,000 pages and said...
Objection, argument.
Rephrase the question.
So how did you do this? How did you go about deciding which pages to give the DA and which pages not to give the DA?
There's a lot of confidentiality between messages with people online, in this case with Facebook. There's a lot of messaging with the defendant and other individuals, females, males, and I only pulled the information that linked both Vanessa Robinson, Adriana Walker, and the defendant. There was too much information with and contact with other individuals that I felt was not necessary to include in this investigation. That was my decision.
Officer Martinez, did you delete some items off the Facebook?
I did not.
Officer Martinez, on the profile, Raymond Davis, 3388630, was there any other individual using that Facebook profile that contacted the alleged victim?
I'm going to object as vague. I don't...
Can you state your question again, please?
Basically, what I'm saying, officer, is did any other individuals contact the alleged victim, Vanessa Robinson, through the Raymond Davis Facebook page? Or was it just Raymond Davis contact?
I don't know, sir. I can't show that someone did.
I'd like to try to refresh your memory by
So, Mr. Davis, just so I can understand the question, you're asking him if someone was using the Raymond Davis Facebook account to contact the victim that was not you. And
right.
That, is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And your answer was what? So that you wouldn't be able to state that, to tell?
I can't prove that, Your Honor.
Okay. And sorry, what was the next thing?
I'd like to refresh his memory.
What?
I got page 7093. I won't make any exhibits. and 7-0.
Those are the Facebook records?
Yes, 7-0-9-2 and 7-0-9-3.
So you're asking to admit the Facebook records into evidence?
I'm asking him to refresh his memory by reading this.
Okay, so you're asking to refresh his recollection?
Yes.
All right. Would you, Marshall Kelly, would you please show Ms. Collins, do you have a copy, correct?
I do.
Oh, could you please show the detective?
Do you remember reading that page?
I did read that page.
So, what's the individual that's messaging her from that page name?
The author is Raymond Davis.
Yes, and who's messaging her from that?
Sir, the author is Raymond Davis.
I understand who the author is, but if you see the message to message, you see different names in the message to message?
I do, sir.
So, is it another individual in the inbox?
In the first message that you're referring to, it says, "This is Kelly."
Kelly?
Yes, sir.
Can you read for the court what it says?
The message that I'm seeing, it says, recipient Vanessa Robinson, author Raymond Davis, sent on March 25th, 2015. This is Kelly. I'll tell Ray you hit him up. You have a number you want me to give him? ?
Okay, now read the rest of it.
Your Honor, the state's going to at least ask that you admit this conversation now that we've started to read some of it out of context. I believe that's marked as States 5 up there. I have no objection to its admission, but I do object to reading it out of context.
So we're not just going to read pieces of the document. So do you have any objection to the entire document coming in as evidence?
Then no, I have an objection to that. I want that to come in.
So you didn't just
get a piece. Well, Your Honor, if... Okay. If... Oh, well, I don't want to question you. If you look through 2,000 pages of Facebook records, and you see other people in this alleged Raymond Davis inbox, would that create doubt in your mind? Any doubt in your mind?
Objection, vague, legal conclusion.
So you're asking him if he reviewed the documents. So are you saying, is this a hypothetical, or this is, did you review those documents? Okay, so a hypothetical is sustained as speculation. If you have a specific question about what he did in this case, then I'm happy to go forward with a different question.
So again, Officer Martinez, are you a numbers person?
I'm sorry, are you a what?
Numbers person.
Are you a numbers person? Are you good with numbers?
Sir, I'm a detective with the police department.
Are you good with numbers?
Right. I don't know how to answer that, sir.
Can you count?
Yes, I can.
So, I'm going to pose this in a question that don't get me objected. Officer Martinez, what's the email link to that profile, Facebook profile? What's the email?
To which profile, sir?
The one you did work on, Raymond Davis. Not the poker star one, but Raymond Davis.
I don't know if I attached an email to the evidence I presented, but I believe it may have came with the downloaded information.
Do you know, Officer Martinez, that every Facebook profile comes with an email?
Yes, sir.
So tell me the email of this profile.
I don't have the records in front of me, sir.
Where are they at?
They're still in the portal.
Can we go into the portal and get them?
I could, yes, sir.
So why wouldn't you bring them so we can know the email that goes to them?
I did not bring that information with me, sir.
So, basically saying, you got a Facebook profile that you are claiming to be a defendant, but you have no email to it. Is that what you're saying, officer?
There's no email attached to these documents here, but there was, if I recall correctly, there's emails and phone numbers and names attached to Facebook user profiles.
So again, I ask you, why do you bring them?
These are the pieces of the Facebook documentation that I included with the investigation. It's not to say that I don't have that information.
Can you obtain that information?
The information is within the Facebook portal, sir.
So I'm looking at this and it says user identification number, email address, date, timestamp, account creation date, most recent logins. Do you have, Officer Martinez, do you have the most recent login from this Facebook profile?
Without the records in front of me, sir, I don't know what the recent
login is. Is there any way we can go on recess and you can go get the records, Officer Martinez?
I can't call recess, sir.
No. Okay. If we went on recess, hypothetically speaking, we'll get the records. The email.
I can provide the records that Facebook provided me, yes.
So, why do you provide this? I mean, do you think that's relevant, Officer Martinez, to identify a person by having the email and the Facebook?
I made the identification, sir, with the profiles provided and made the identification to the subjects involved.
I thought you said Claudiento, the juvenile facility made the identification. I mean, I thought that's what was said. I thought you said you mailed it off and they did the identification process for you. That means you didn't do the identification process. Somebody else did it.
Well, I had you identified prior to the photo lineup. And based on my experience and the information I had gathered, I had a good possible lead that it was you. And that information was...
Go ahead and finish, please. Go ahead and finish, and then you can ask your next question.
Okay. That information is then, in this case, sent to the victim so she can make the identification as well, which was...
Now you want to tell us your lead?
I'm sorry, sir?
Do you want to tell us your lead, the good lead that you had?
The lead was the name provided in this case. The, I believe, was the first prefix of the phone number, 562. The lead was also the general area of what the victim described, Vegas Valley and South Nellis Boulevard. And the apartment complexes within that area.
So your lead was a phone number? Three numbers of a phone number, right? And is that what you're telling us?
That's correct. That's one of my, one of the investigative leads I had.
So you didn't think of just a match to Facebook with the email? You didn't consider that?
I don't understand the question.
When you got all the information from Facebook and everyone, you didn't say, okay, I have all this, let me try to match the email to this case. Or IP address.
No, because I believe that Facebook address or the user profile was the defendant's.
Because you believed it.
That's correct.
But you didn't have no evidence that it was the defendant's.
Just the evidence that I had provided Facebook and the evidence that they in turn provided me.
You're 562. Your lead.
I'm sorry, sir?
You're 562. Your lead. Your secret lead. Your lead that you got was the 562.
Yeah, that prefix, I believe, is somewhere on the Facebook records, so I was able to match, match the name.
So instead of matching an email and an IP address, you just matched three digits of a phone number.
That's not all I matched, sir.
I would like, can you explain?
I matched the name of the person, and I also matched the user profile picture to the description given by Vanessa Robinson.
But you also matched that and did all that to the poker star Raymond Davis account. Am I correct?
That's correct.
Your Honor, may we approach?
Yeah.
So my assumption is if he keeps pushing on this, I mean, he has prior arrests, 1998, Hayward, California, lewdness with a minor, the 2004 case here, if he keeps pushing this, I'm sure that went into the investigation, and I just don't want that door to be opened, and I hadn't really talked to the detective about that because I didn't think we would be on this for this length of time.
Sure. So you need to be really careful because you're opening the door.
The jury's getting tired.
Right, that's what I've been trying
so
to do.
So we gotta stop having her object.
No. Mr. Davis, if you've gone into something, we're moving on. So I have told you multiple times. From now on, if you ask something that has already been asked, I will admonish you to move on. This jury has been hearing from this person. It's not about your objection.
I agree,
it's about
Your
Honor. Inability to move on. Pick your questions. They have to be within her direct examination, and then we're moving on.
Okay.
We can't be doing this. Yeah. We are in the second week of trial. We are on the second witness. I've never seen anything like this, ever. Ever. They are getting...
Because she's slowing us down, Your Honor.
Excuse me?
She's slowing us down.
So
she keeps walking us to this bench.
You chose to represent yourself, and that is within your rights,
mm-hmm.
and everybody respects that. But on recess, you may want to speak to Mr. Klaus about some of the strategic
we're
decisions.
Going to
yeah,
I agree.
Yeah. You go
we're not
go
going
ahead.
On. My feet are killing me. The jury, awesome. Let the
you
jury.
Have a choice. Keep going.
This mistake on the date, when the guy also proofread and gave a date. Why didn't you fix this one?
Facebook had recognized, because we had sent a preservation letter of the exact dates, they had recognized what the dates I wanted, and so they had sent me the information that I requested.
They hadn't sent it, is that what you said?
But they had sent it with the information provided.
So with the wrong dates, two different times.
Objection, mischaracterizes the testimony.
Sustained.
With the mistake, how much time did you have to fix this mistake?
I had enough time to fix it.
You had enough time?
Mm-hmm.
So why didn't you fix it?
Okay, we have gone over this subject multiple times. It has been asked and answered. Move on.
Your Honor, that
asked
was the first
and
one.
Answered. Move on.
Officer Martinez, do you make a lot of mistakes?
Objection, argumentative.
Sustained.
So, during your interview with the alleged victim, Vanessa Robson, you did a laundry list on what she alleged happened to her. Do you recall?
Yes.
Can you tell the court what was the things that she said was done to her?
So, in my interview with Vanessa Robinson, she alleged she had went over to Mr. Davis's apartment and specifically recalled the living room area, and she recalled something to the effect of, you do a favor for me, I'll do a favor for you. And Mr. Davis initiated the contact by placing her hand onto his, she said, private area.
Officer Martinez, that's
excuse
not
me.
The laundry list.
That's, no, excuse me, you need to let him finish his answer, and then you may ask your next question. Please interrupt witness. Detective Martinez, proceed.
So Mr. Davis, she stated Mr. Davis had grabbed her hand and placed it on his penis over the clothing, and said that he didn't want sex, but asked for oral sex. And Ms. Robinson recalls giving him oral sex for about 5 minutes and then stopped. And then she recalls a time when she stated she was with Adriana Walker inside his apartment, and just stated that Mr. Davis instructed them to get into robes, and they had been drinking alcohol, and she believed, Vanessa Robinson believed, that he had slipped something into Adriana's drink, and he offered both of them to shower.
Object.